cursing, pouring, live on Mockingbird Hill. I try to stay green next door to the rodeo grill, where she worked at night in the neon light. But then try to stay saloon, and the cattle trucks would come and go by the light of the Mockingbird moon. A dark and weary driver came in for a beer last night. There was blood on his knuckles, looked like maybe there'd been a fight. Cause Sandra, she told him, looks like you need a drink. From under his hat, he squinted, gave her a little wink. I could use a double whiskey, but it would not save my soul. I could use $100, but it would not make me whole. I could use some understanding, no need for no excuse. Oh, let's just second-hand it. Only love can cut me loose. Cassandra swept the floors and then turned out the light. She locked the well-worn door like she'd done so many nights. A cattle truck was idle next door to the rodeo grill. As the full moon came rising over on Mockingbird Hill, she could tell that he was waiting by the sound of his rumbling pipes. His truck was parked sideways across a string of yellow stripes. His window rolled down slowly, Cassandra stopped for a blink. He asked if she was lonesome. She didn't even stop to think. I could use a double whiskey, but it would not save my soul. I could use $100, but it would not make me whole. I could use some understanding. No need for no excuse. Oh, that's just second-hand. Only love can cut me loose. That truck pulled back into the night. She watched it slowly fade as it curved around the barbed wire fence her great-granddaddy had made. With the rising of the moon came memories of a certain man who once was here but now was gone far beyond Evanston Lane. Cassandra, Corey, lived on Mockingbird Hill by the tri-state arena next door to the rodeo grill, where she worked at night in the neon light of the tri-state saloon.